So we've got our palm tree here, and what we're going to do is we're going to make a little desert island to go with it. So first thing we're going to do is we're just going to hide the palm tree. So basically we don't interfere with it while we're building the desert island. And you can do this by up in the top right hand corner. If you find all of the shapes that we've used, so we've used the cylinder, so we just click on the eye. Okay, and you can see it's disappeared. We used the planes, remember, for the different leaves. So I'm just going to click on the four of those to hide them. Okay, they're still there. If we want to get them back at any time, we just click on the eye again and it will bring them back. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to start building the island. Okay, so I'm just going to zoom out a little bit here, and I am going to go to add mesh plane. Okay, and I'm going to, in the scale part, so just in scale, I'm just going to make this reasonably large. Okay, so I'm going to pull out the scale a couple of times. Let's make it sort of that sort of size. That'll do. Cool. So what we're now going to do, so this is going to become the this is going to become like the sand in our island, if you like, and we're going to surround it with some sea. Now we've got our planes, so we've now got to edit this. So we're going to go into edit mode at the top left here. Okay, and we're going to go to this menu here that says edge, and then we're going to go to subdivide. Okay, and the reason we're going to do this is we're going to use certain sections of our plane, and we're going to pull them up to make them these sort of island sort of bumpy shape. Okay, now we can just keep clicking subdivide, but an easier way of doing this is down the bottom here, bottom left, we've got this little subdivide menu, and we can click in there, and we're going to just change it to 10 to start with. Okay, so this divides our island into sort of 10 by 10 grid. All right, and remember, if you make any mistakes, just Control Z will undo. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to get the selection tool, so make sure that's selected up there, and we're just going to click and we're going to hold down shift. We're going to select a sort of middle area of the island, so something a bit like this. Okay, so this is going to be the sort of bump, if you like, the sort of bump that's going to become the island. So I'm just going to select this area here. And if you remember back to what we did before when we did the leaves, when we subdivided the leaves using the knife tool, and we moved a section of the leaf to make it bend, and this is what we're going to do with this part of the island. We're going to kind of pull it up to make a little hump, all right? But what we're going to want to do to make the kind of hump a bit more accurate, we're going to subdivide this area even more. So we're going to subdivide this into more squares. So like we did before, we go to edge, subdivide, and you can see it's divided into lots more squares, and I'm just going to do the same again to divide it into even more squares. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to make the sort of center of the island, and we're going to select one square roughly in the middle, doesn't have to be exact, but roughly in the middle, and we've got to make sure, remember, we've got this proportional editing button selected. Okay, because that's going to pull the rest of the island up with it. So we're going to go to the move tool, and I'm going to go on the Z axis, and I'm just going to pull up the island like that. So it's like a little sort of bump. Okay. Then what we're going to do is we're going to repeat that on other areas of the island as well. So we're going to pull up maybe, let's say, that one. I'm going to move a bit up, so we've got like another bump. Okay. And maybe we'll do one over here. And we'll make that a slightly smaller bump. I don't know. You sort of do it however you want, really. So maybe something a bit like that. And just go round and make a, however you want it to look, really. So let's just make a sort of little ridge, I think, like that. And maybe we'll just do one more sort of bump, maybe up there. Just see how that looks. Okay, yeah, cool. All right, lovely. Might just do a couple more. It's a little sort of bumpy island, this one. Okay, maybe something like that, I don't know. Let's just orbit around and see what we've got. Okay, that looks all right. Okay, so you can go around and make the rest of the island a bit more bumpy and humpy and so on. Okay, but we'll go with that for the moment, I think. Okay, so once we've kind of got our island where we want it in terms of the shape, what we're going to do is now add the sea. Okay, so we're going to add another mesh. Okay, so we're going to go object mode, because we don't want to edit at this point. Add mesh plane. Okay, so the plane, there's a little square in there. This is going to be the sea. So I'm going to pull this out so it's roughly the size of the sand area. Okay, so it might take you a couple of sort of mouse edits, a bit like that. Okay. And then what we're going to do is we're going to use the move tool. I'm going to move the sea up. Okay, so you can see there it kind of covers the bottom part of the island. So we've got this kind of bit sticking out. Okay. Now, if you find, like, randomly as you move the sea, the island is moving at the same time, just deselect proportional editing at the top there, because this time we don't want things to stick together and move together. Okay, we want to move them separately. Now, we can give these areas a bit of colour. So you've done this before. So I've just selected the sand area. And then in the materials bit down here, we can just do new. And we can call it sand. And we can give it colour. Okay, whatever colour you fancy. And then we can do the same with the C as well, so I'm just going to select the C and C and make that blue. Okay, whatever blue you fancy, maybe something like that. Okay, so we've then got our island. Okay, now one thing you can have a little play around with if you like, I'm not going to do it here, but there's different types of kind of surface, so you have a little play with those, just see what they look like. Remember, you can use Control Z to go back if something doesn't look too good. Now from this point we want to go back to our palm tree and make it visible again. So you can see here top right where we've got the eyes closed, you can just click on those now and we can put our palm tree back. Okay, and as you can see it's kind of growing out the middle there. So what I might want to do is select it and then move it. Okay, so I can hold down shift, click on the trunk, click on the leaves, just making sure I'm not selecting the sea or the sand. Okay, and then I can go to the move tool and then I can kind of position it wherever I like on the island, maybe something like that. Okay, all right. So we can have a little look around. Okay, and we can move the light source if we want. Oops, wrong thing there, that was the sand. I think my light source is underneath the sea for some reason, somewhere around it. I know there it is. So maybe I'll just move that because it's quite close. Move it up a little bit. Okay. I don't think that's particularly happy, I'm not spending it. But yeah, it's underneath, that's why it's gone. There we go, that's better. Okay. So that would be the equivalent of the sun, essentially. So we have our palm tree and desert island. So from here, you can go on, you can add some other bits, maybe some, you can duplicate some trees, you could make the sand a bit bigger, you could add some sort of rocks, you could add coconuts, add a shipwreck, you could even animate the sea using keyframes, remember? You can animate the sea going up and down if you fancy trying that as well. So have a little play and see if we can get our desert island built.